Apple never mentioned these changes with iOS 26.1. But they directly affect the repair industry. How will third-party parts behave on the new system? We tested screens and batteries that technicians care about most. Let's start with iPhone 11. On iOS 26.0.1, we found that iPhone 11 replaced with a third-party screen did not trigger the unknown part message. We thought Apple loosened restrictions for older models. But on iOS 26.1, the unknown part message popped up again. For iPhone 12 to 14 series, we are using REWA's Diagnostic-compatible screens. Install the screen without the original front sensor cable. After it passes Repair Assistant and reads Used, then install the front sensor Flux. Our tests show that for these models, the original front sensor Flux is not crucial for the screen to pass Repair Assistant. For iPhone 15 and 16, things get more interesting. We transplant the original screen IC to an aftermarket screen of 15 Pro Max. Transfer the original front sensor Flux to the aftermarket screen. As expected, the system shows no unknown part alert. Then we install an unoriginal front sensor Flux to the same screen. Install the screen, go to Parts and Service History, and attempt the Repair Assistant. It fails, and a display unknown part message appears. It is detected as an unknown part by the iOS system. The same happens with iPhone 16 series. Then we install a diagnostic compatible screen and run Repair Assistant. After it passes, we install the original front sensor Flux. No unknown part message pops up, and the parts and service history reads used. When we change the front sensor Flux to a non-original one, the screen is detected as an unknown part. The test's results suggest that iOS 26.1 has introduced part pairing between the front sensor Flux and motherboard. Apple has once again expanded its part pairing restrictions. Next, let's look at the battery. This iPhone 15 Pro originally has 87% battery health. First, we replace it with a battery cell, transfer the original BMS board. And install a Refox battery tag on Flux. No unknown part message appears, but the battery health still shows 87%. A reflash is required to recalibrate the battery health. After the reflash, the battery health reads 100%. Next, we test a diagnostic compatible battery. it passes the repair assistant and is recognized as used. The test results show both battery solutions perform the same on iOS 26.1 as they do on iOS 18. To conclude our test results, iOS 26.1 enforces stricter part pairing for screen repairs. The new system introduces part pairing between the front sensor flex and the motherboard. To remove unknown part message or pass the repair assistant, the original flex cable is mandatory.